Dear students, welcome to online class on digital image processing. Digital images and videos play an important role in modern day communication. Therefore, it is said that an image is worth more than a thousand words. Such is the significance of images. Of course, a video is nothing but a sequence of several images. After watching this video, you will be able to explain the basic concept of digital image processing and understand the significance of digital image processing. Now, let us have an introduction to digital image processing. The title digital image processing consists of three words: digital, image, and processing. Let us consider the meaning of each word one by one. Okay, let us first consider the word image. What is an image? As you see in this slide, an image is a two-dimensional representation of a three-dimensional scene. The coordinates of this two-dimensional space are x-coordinate and y-coordinate. In the context of image processing, normally the horizontal axis is termed as y-coordinate and the vertical axis is termed as x-coordinate. More formally, an image may be defined as a two-dimensional function f of x, y, where x and y are the spatial coordinates and the amplitude of f is called the intensity or gray level. Okay, having known what is an image is, now let us look at the term digital image. If the spatial coordinates x and y and the amplitude f all are finite and discrete, then such image is known as a digital image. Obviously, the images stored in the memory of a computer are digital images because a computer memory can hold only finite and discrete quantities. Okay, here in the first figure, you can see an image with varying intensity. You can see the horizontal y-axis and the vertical x-axis, and also the origin, which is represented by 00. In the computer language, an image is nothing but a matrix whose elements represent the intensity values of pixels. In this image, you can see that the black pixel is marked red and is represented by 0, and the white pixel is represented by 255. The other element values vary according to the intensity of pixels. Okay, then what is meant by a pixel? If you go on zooming any image, you may see the squares like this. These squares are termed as pixels or pels. So, pixel is defined as the smallest controllable element of a picture. After knowing what is a pixel and what is a digital image, let us now consider digital image processing. For the quick understanding of the term digital image processing, consider the two images. The first image is processed using some algorithm in the computer to have a clear perception. You know that generally our passport photos or any photos developed at the studios are smarter than our real appearance. This is because these photos are processed by using digital computers. Hence, the term digital image processing refers to the manipulation of a digital image by means of a processor. In this subject, you are going to study the theory and algorithm behind this digital image processing. Okay, then what is the significance of digital image processing? The digital image processing is motivated by three major applications. The first one is improvement of pictorial information for human perception. As shown in the previous slide, enhancement of an image gives better visual perception and better look. We will consider the theory and methods for image enhancement in the subsequent lectures. The most important significance of digital image processing is in autonomous machine applications. This application has entered almost every field of our life, starting from office automation to military applications. At the end of the next class, I will provide a list of applications for digital image processing. One more significance of image processing is the efficient storage and transmission of images using image compression. We will consider these factors one by one. Considering the first application, improvement of pictorial information for human perception, we shall discuss two major examples: noise filtering and content enhancement. You can observe some noise in the first image. By using some computer algorithm called filtering, it is possible to remove this noise from the image, and thereby we can improve the pictorial information. You are seeing a popular test image in the image processing field called Lena image. The first image is whitish in color, that is, it has a low contrast. In image processing, there are methods like histogram equalization which can enhance the contrast of the image. We will consider this in detail in the second unit. The image blurring may be due to improper focusing of the camera lens or due to either motion of the camera or the object during image capturing. The blurring of the image can be corrected by using image processing techniques. In certain applications like identification of severity of brain tumor, the tumor area or the region of interest is required to be enhanced by using local methods. Here in the first column, you are seeing two aerial images captured remotely using satellites. They have low contrast. After contrast enhancement, we can observe more details on the images. This is an ultrasound color Doppler test image. The radiologist can find the direction and velocity of the blood in the vein by using these images. This will help them to identify the blood clots in the veins. There are techniques in image processing that can represent direction and velocity of the pixels. One such method is to use image gradients, which we will discuss later. Another similar method but used in weather forecasting is image enhancement for detecting the intensity of hurricane. The first image shown here is an input image, and the image processing algorithm enhances the pictorial information to determine the intensity of hurricane. The image processing is mostly motivated by autonomous machine applications. We can list hundreds of examples for this, but for the understanding purpose, we will consider two examples here. Consider an automatic bottle filling application used by an industry which manufactures some liquid chemical. If the industry sells partially filled bottles or empty bottles, then the goodwill of the company will be lost. The image processing techniques can be used to build an automatic quality control to check this criteria. The next example that we are discussing here is automatic PCB checking. It is almost impossible to check the quality of subtle electronic boards manually. There are various image processing techniques to check the quality of printed circuit boards. As I told earlier, the examples for autonomous machine applications are not limited to few. We can list many examples under this. Image compression had been one of the important areas in the image processing. Image compression is used to reduce the disk space required for storing the image in the memory of the computer. Basically, there are two types of image compressions. One is called lossless image compression and the other is called lossy image compression. Lossless image compression is used especially in the medical field, where regular diagnosis of patients generate huge image data to be stored without losing the quality of the images. On the other hand, the minute details of images do not contribute much for the human perception. In such applications, lossy image compression may be used. Basically, the image compression is done exploiting the redundancy of pixel values. If you consider any fruit in this image, the color of the fruit is almost homogeneous. Hence, these pixels exhibit redundancy in their values. Hence, to represent a fruit, say orange, all the pixels of the orange image need not be saved in the memory of the computer. Instead, it can be represented in a compact form. Moreover, if the size of the image is less, then it can be quickly transmitted even through a low bandwidth transmission media. To summarize the previous topic, the image processing is motivated by improvement of pictorial information for human perception, image processing for autonomous machine applications, efficient storage and transmission of digital images.